Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. I will introduce TestRail, a powerful test management tool used by testers and developers worldwide to organize and manage their testing efforts more efficiently. By choosing TestRail, you unlock a key ingredient to help you prepare your recipe for success. In this tutorial series, you'll learn the basics of TestRail, from documenting your test cases, plans, and runs to capturing real-time results and generating meaningful reports. If your team is new to TestRail, we highly recommend forwarding this training video to all your team members. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell, never to forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. All right, let's get started. In this video, you're going to learn how to add an attachment as part of your automated test results and upload it using the TestRail CLI. You might want to do this when a test fails, and your automation tool captures a screenshot at the point of failure. You can upload this image along with test results to TestRail. Let's see how. For example, I'm using a JUnit and Selenium project, and I'm using the specification-first approach, meaning that I have documented test cases in TestRail before automating them. So, the CLI will map the automated test cases with the documentation and upload the results without duplicating the test cases. You can see the test cases here in my repository, and they have the IDs C100, C101, C109, and C110. Now let's see the automation code on the editor. I have automated three of them, and I added the test case IDs from TestRail to my code using the annotation feature. To use this feature, you need to include the TestRail JUnit extensions to your pom.xml file. And at the top of the test class, just add the extend with annotation with the TestRail test reporter parameter resolver.class. The TestRail JUnit extensions also allow you to add the TestRail test reporter argument to your test methods. Then setting properties is as simple as using the setProperty method with the desired key and value. Here I want to pass an attachment as part of the result, so I'm going to add the TestRail test reporter class and pass the object of this class as a part of the parameter, which is custom reporter. In this class test, you have the method setProperty, and in this method you have the property TestRail attachment br1. When using this property, you can specify the path of the attachment that you would like to upload. In this case, I have a PNG image under sample reports. Let's execute the tests and upload the results. First, just making sure that TestRail CLI is installed on my system. With the command pip install TRCLI, you can see it's already installed. Let's run the tests. As these are Java tests, I'm using Maven clean compile test. This command is going to run the tests and create an XML report in the target folder. You can use the TestRail CLI to parse test automation results from nearly any test automation tool or framework, if that tool can export test results in a JUnit-style XML file. As you can see, three tests were executed, and out of them, one is failed. This is fine because I deliberately created an invalid test to fail, and it has also created the corresponding XML file for the next step, which is sending the results to TestRail with the attachment. For that, I will use the TestRail CLI command like this. The minus Y option skips the prompts and creates all the entities you need in TestRail, which is useful when running the CLI and CI/CD pipelines. The minus C command is for the configuration. In this case, all my configurations are in the TRCLI config.iml file. Let's quickly check that out. Here you will find the host, which is the TestRail instance, and the name of the project where you want the results uploaded. If I go to that project in TestRail, you will see my documented test cases there. Back to the configuration, I also have the username, the password, and the title of my new test run. In the TRCLI command, I'm using the parse JUnit keyword, and then case matcher as property. I already mentioned this is the specification-first approach, and I'm passing the test case IDs using the TestRail annotation. For last, the option minus F mentions where exactly the automated test report is located. Let's execute the command. The TestRail CLI is going to verify the information, process the test cases, create a test run, and add the test results. As you can see in this line here, it has also uploaded one attachment for one test result, all in 11 seconds. Let's go to the TestRail instance and verify if the image is there. This is the test run that has just been created. Clicking on it, you'll see immediately a summary of the results and scrolling down all the tests. Let's dig in further and check the test presence of the demo link on the home page. This test case has passed, and here you can find the attachment. This is how you add an attachment as part of automated test results and send it to TestRail using the CLI. Check our other TestRail YouTube videos for more tutorials like this one. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.